God is what's left when everything else is removed. Think about the thing that I just said to you right now. I bet you the first thing that your mind registered is that this is something that's profound, right? Now, before you even knew what it meant, you registered it like that. And if I said the same statement to, let's say, one person who's religious and one person who's not religious, it would mean two different things. So why am I telling you this? Because the fact of the matter is that reality is a lot more subjective than you think. And just by understanding that, you have the ability to shape reality around you so you perceive it however you want. So that leads me to the book of the week. The book of the week is The Brain That Changes Itself by Dr. Norman Doidge. And this book is a fantastic book. It's written by a psychiatrist who went out to explore these case studies of various patients and how, through just unbelievable odds, changed the way their brain functioned. Stroke victims, people with cancer who suffered through a lot of pain, trauma victims, and even more remarkable, a woman who literally had half a brain, and somehow that half of her brain was able to take over the functions of the other brain. So how is that possible? It's possible through a concept called neuroplasticity, meaning that your brain has the capability to be plastic and change over time. In an ever-changing world, right, nature fortunately gave us a brain that actually can change, right? And many of you remember the book called Influence, A Psychology of Persuasion, written by Dr. Robert Cialdini. It was written about 30 years ago. He popularized a phrase that's been around since the time of Freud, which is that neurons that fire together, wire together, right? So that means that we have to be very careful of the things that we do and the way we perceive things. So if there's, say, for example, a task at work that you absolutely hate doing, if every time you have to do this thing, you start to curse about it, you're getting upset, you're getting angry, you're literally wiring your brain to hate that part of your job. And guess what? If you hate that part of your job, you're not going to be very good at it, and you're not going to like it, and you're going to be miserable. So what about this? And think about somewhere in his library, I have it, Zig Ziglar's How to Stay Motivated. He had a great saying in that book, which is, hey, if you don't like your job, that's okay. Fall in love with the way you do the job. This all is rooted in the idea of neuroplasticity, because your brain can change. And those people who are able to imagine, and more importantly, visualize the kind of reality that they want, you can slowly mold yourself into that. Say, for example, let's go back to the task at hand. Let's say there's a part of your job you absolutely hate. Let's just say it's writing out certain documents, right? Well, what if you're able to do those documents while listening to music you really love, right? Now, even though you might hate this one aspect, if you pair it with something you love, eventually these two things, they're not differentiated. They end up leaking into each other, right? And forming into one thing. And if the thing that you pick that you love, you know, is a lot stronger than the thing that you dislike, it will slowly engulf and change over time. And then, voila, by a miracle, you love the thing that you used to hate. So I think it's a remarkable book. The case studies in here are really fantastic, especially for those of you who are students of neuroscience who are interested in that. You're going to love this book because it really breaks it down. Now, again, yes, our old evolutionary brains have some mechanism and machinery in there that it's hard to change. This primitive brainstem is different because even though saber-toothed tigers don't exist, we still get that sense of feeling as if it's life or death if something bad happens. Let's just say, you know, we're late to a meeting, right? But by taking over and being in control of our own brains, we can start to make the neural connections that we need, not only to survive, but to thrive in the ever-changing world that we're in. You have a lot more power than you realize, and I think by reading this book, taking my advice to heart, you will see that as well. No matter how bad your situation is, you can do it. Just like the great movie, I think it's called Life is Beautiful, I think it's Life is Beautiful, where it's a story about a father and son who were in a Nazi concentration camp in Auschwitz, who were, you know, suffering and being brutalized and watching people die around them. The father told the son that, hey, this is all a game. We're just trying to see who could survive. It's a big game and we get points and everything. And this guy literally taught his son how to change his perception of a Nazi concentration camp so that his son can survive, not only survive, but thrive in these types of situations. So if remarkably people like that could do this in Nazi concentration camps, you can definitely do that in the modern day, whether it's in your job, your personal life, your family life, you know, whatever it might be. So that's the book of the week. Definitely go out and get it. And as always, Happy Wisdom Wednesday, and I'll see you next week.